Le directeur du Fonds du patrimoine mondial de l'Afrique, M. Varissou, chers participants mauriciens du continent africain, chers amis du patrimoine, mesdames et messieurs, bonjour. Permettez-moi de vous souhaiter une heureuse journée du patrimoine mondial africain. Je suis très heureux de participer à cette visioconférence et de pouvoir célébrer avec vous notre patrimoine africain. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank the Upper Amasiga Trust Fund, Le Monde Heritage Trust Fund, the National Heritage Trust Fund, and the Center for African Culture for the initiative in setting up this platform and to promote the notion of World Heritage Sites. Please also allow me to commend the UNESCO Regional Office for Eastern Africa, the African World Heritage Fund, and different stakeholders in the field for the various initiatives to mark the African World Heritage Day. It is crucial that through our events and activities, we stress upon our historical treasures of the African continent and take every opportunity to involve our younger generations. Ladies and gentlemen, the General Conference of UNESCO in November 2015 proclaimed that the African World Heritage Day be celebrated on the 5th of May with the aim to provide an opportunity for people around the world and particularly Africans to celebrate the continent's unique cultural and natural heritage. With the aim of strengthening capacities and ensuring transmission for safeguarding the intangible cultural heritage of Mauritius, the traditional Mauritian Siga, the Gidgawai, the Siga Tambu Rodrigue, and very recently, the Siga Tambu Chagos were inscribed by the UNESCO. Mauritius is also home to two UNESCO World Heritage Sites, Le Monde Cultural Landscape and Apravasighat. These heritage sites are a living symbol of the history and contribution of the indentured laborers and the slaves in making Mauritius a prosperous nation. The World Heritage status has contributed to Mauritius being widely recognized for its rich history of slave and indenture and has developed solid collaboration with numerous partners throughout the world with the setting up of the Indentured Labour Route Project and participate in the Slave Route Project. The World Heritage status of the Upper Amasighat has led to the development of a new framework for the protection of heritage in Mauritius. The first major conservation project led in Mauritius with the assistance of ICOMOS from 2004 to 2010 has led to the development of a framework for the conservation of built heritage. Two planning documents, the PPG 6 and the AAP 01, were prepared to integrate our heritage within development strategies. The objective is to enhance heritage and preserve the unique character of the capital of the capital city of Port Louis of Mauritius. Likewise, the government of Mauritius has committed to protect and preserve the Le Monde cultural landscape, which is a strong symbol of resistance against slavery. The opening of the Trouchény Open Air Museum in February 2020 is another important step in the cultural interpretation and sustainable development that aims to promote Le Monde cultural landscape as an authentic international cultural spot in Mauritius. Ladies and gentlemen, my speech will remain incomplete if I fail to mention the launching of the first phase of the Intercontinental Slavery Museum by the government of Mauritius, which is found just next to the Apravasighat World Heritage Site. This is a powerful, tangible symbol of a shared history and shared ancestral heritage. This museum being set up in one of the oldest buildings in Mauritius, built by slaves in the 18th century, translates the government's commitment to raise awareness on this dark period of shared history with Africa and to preserve the cultural heritage which boiled down to shape along with the indentured heritage. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we are duty-bound to preserve, protect, and promote our heritage. On this day, let us commit together to make our country, our continent, and our world a better place to live in and preserve for our children the treasures of humanity, our history, the intangible legacies, and the built heritage of our forefathers, and the marvels of nature, which should be kept for the benefit of future generations. In this endeavor, I have no doubt that UNESCO and the African World Heritage Fund will always lend us its support. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish you all a fruitful conference and thank you for your attention.